Let us move on to next topic, that is a complete OpenGL program. So let us take one example which is going to draw a particular line segment on the computer display screen. Okay, so one of the example I'm going to take here, that is you want to draw a line segment on the computer screen or the window what you are going to create. So for setting the line on the particular screen, you have to first set the background color of the window what you are going to display. Okay, so for displaying the window, we have to choose the background color. Okay, so here one of the function in OpenGL, okay, that is provided here is GL clear color, which is going to clear the background to the respective color what you have chosen. So here we have set GL clear color 1.0, 1.0, 1.0, and 0.0. That means suppose here first value, that is 1.0, represents red color, and the next value, that is 1.0, represents green color, RGB, okay, blue color. Next value we have 1.0, that is you have set all the values, that is red color to 1.0, green to 1.0, and blue to 1.0. That means you are setting the background to white. So when you are going to set all the RGB values to 1.0, you get a white background on the screen. Okay, that is here in this particular this example I am going to take here. It's displaying white color. And what about the last value you have here? That is 0.0. Okay, that is fourth parameter. See, first three parameters are set to 1.0, and the last parameter what I have written is 0.0 is the alpha value. So here alpha value is representing whether your screen has to be in transparent or opaque mode. Okay, so here 0.0 is representing that it is a transparent background. Okay, white background is a transparent background. If you are setting it as 1.0, it will be, if the alpha value is set to 1.0, that means you will be having a opaque background. Okay, opaque in the sense if you cannot see through that particular object. Okay, transparent means you can see through. Is it? So now here the example here we have got, in that example we are going to set the GL clear color to 1.0, 1.0, 1.0, and 0.0. So in this particular example, your OpenGL function will set the background color to white background, and the alpha value you have chosen is 0.0. that means it is a you are getting a transparent background. Okay, suppose think that I am giving the different value as GL clear color 0.0, 0.0, the RGB colors all are set to 0.0, think that. Okay, and the alpha value is also set to 0.0. that means if all the RGB values are 0.0, then you are setting the black color background. Okay, then so the all the combinations of red, green, and blue are set to 0.0, then you are going to get a black color background. And if alpha value is set to 1.0, in that case you may have a opaque background. Okay, now here in this thing, alpha is you are getting a transparent background. Okay, transparent background. Although the GL clear command assigns the color to the display window, it does not put the display window on the screen. Okay, now our function, whatever you have written already, it is in the previous slide, I have written GL clear color command, is it, or the function. It was setting the background to white background, is it? display window to white background. But that clear command, whatever you have written, will not display the color of the window until you give one more command, that is gl clear. Okay, so one more command should be present in your program to display the color whatever you have assigned earlier. So assignment of the color, okay, for the window will be done by gl clear color function, but displaying that assigned colors will be done by gl clear function. Okay, and the argument to the gl clear function should be given as gl underscore color underscore buffer underscore bit. So this means that whatever the colors you have assigned earlier in the clear gl clear color function will be all in bit values. Okay, so you are specifying that it is bit values in the color buffer. So setting of the background color of the screen is already done. Now we want to set the color for the object what you want to display. The object may be lines or points or a rectangular box, okay, any kind of object it may be, but we have to give certain color for that object. So what is the function you can have in the OpenGL to give the color for the object? Okay, for in this particular example here, we set the object color to be dark green. So we are going to give the coloring function as gl color 3f, okay, and within the bracket we write it as 0.0, 0.4 and 0.2. So now again, as you know, there will be only three main colors, primary colors we have, that is red, green and blue, is it? So now I have set red color to 0.0, green color to 0.4 and blue color to 0.2. okay, so the suffix you can see here, that is 3f. okay, you have a suffix here in the function gl color function, that is 3f. okay, it indicates that we are specifying three colors in our particular object. We have combined three colors and we have formed one color. Okay, that means here when red is 0 and green is with the 0.4 and blue with 0.2, you get a combination of two color, that is green and blue. Okay, I don't exactly what color it may be, but it is a combination of green and blue color. Okay, so here 3 represents, we are using three colors here, mainly RGB colors, and the F indicates that all the values whatever you have represented all are in floating point values. So you can see that 0.0, okay, 0.0 is a floating point value, 0.4 is a floating point value, and 0.2 is also a floating point. So all the colors whatever you have chosen here is a floating point value. So F indicates that it is a floating point value. Okay, and remember that the range of this value, the floating point value, ranges from 0.0 to 1.0. okay, we cannot go beyond this value. Okay, whatever the value you are going to set, it should be within the range, that is 0 to 1 or 0.0 to 1.0. For our first program here, we want to display a line segment. Okay, even though you want to display a line segment, a simple line segment, the OpenGL processes our picture through full three-dimensional viewing operations. So whatever the object you may have, maybe it is a two-dimensional object or a three-dimensional object, the OpenGL processes our any picture through full three-dimensional viewing operations. Okay, so we can set the projection type and the other viewing parameters we need with the two functions in our OpenGL. So what are the two functions here is gl matrix mode, gl underscore projection. Okay, so the object what you want to project on the screen will be all in matrix values, and this projection has to be in orthogonal weaving. So you have GLU ortho 2D with values 0.0, 2.0, 0.0, 150.0. So this specifies that the orthogonal projection is to be used to map the contents of the 2D rectangular area of world coordinates to the screen, and that x coordinate values within this rectangle range from 0.0 to 200 with y coordinate values ranging from 0.0 to 150. Whatever the objects we define within this world coordinate rectangle will be shown within the display window. So that means that suppose I am going to project one line segment, okay, within the this within the window. Okay, what the line segment here, you have a simple line segment, and I have projected it on the screen. Okay, so now for the screen, whatever you have displayed, you are going to set an orthogonal projection, and your object has to be displayed within that orthogonal projection. Okay, so here it is from left, it is 0.0 positions. Okay, left, right, bottom, and top. Okay, so here from left it is 0.0, from right it is 200 positions, and from bottom it is again 0.0. Okay, 0.0, and from top it is 150. Okay, so you get exactly where your line has to be projected on the screen, okay, using this ortho2D function. Okay, you suppose if you display that the line outside this particular orthogonal projected window, okay, your display will be coming out of the screen. Okay, it may display somewhere else. So whatever the line segment you have to display, it has to be displayed within the window what you have created. Okay, so now you are setting here the orthogonal projection with certain values. Okay, you are going to give a boundary for the object where you want to display on the screen. Whatever the objects we define within the world coordinate rectangle will be shown within the display window. Anything outside this coordinate range will not be displayed. So that means, suppose if you have a camera and you have captured a certain object using that camera, okay, you get a photo corresponding to that whatever image you have captured, you get a photo. So now this photo will have a certain reference range. Okay, reference point you will be having. Think that it has displayed an object line segment. Okay, you have captured a line segment, and some other objects also will be present around this around that particular object. Okay, so that will be also captured by the camera. Okay, so now the thing is, you have converted certain world coordinates to device coordinates, is it? So same thing happens in your OpenGL function also. Whatever the world coordinate in the world coordinate system, suppose if you have captured certain object pictures, that it has got its own coordinates, that those coordinates will be all converted to the device coordinates when it's being displayed on the window. Okay, anything outside that range. Okay, so your camera has got certain certain boundary. Okay, that boundary means you cannot capture entire world. It has got certain boundary, depending on the lens whatever you have kept. okay, before an object, okay, we are going to do the focusing the object, okay. So when you focus the object, you can capture a small portion of the world, okay, not entire world. So it has got certain range. So within that range, whatever it falls, that will be displayed. Okay, same way here in the OpenGL also, the world coordinate rectangle, whatever you have, that coordinates will be all converted to device coordinates when it is displayed on the screen. So therefore, GLU function Ortho2D defines the coordinate reference frame within the display window to be 0.0 and 0.0 at the lower left corner of the window. So that means here, suppose if your computer screen you have like this, okay, now you have to display a particular object, this line segment, on the screen, and your orthogonal 2D function has set values as from lower left corner it is 0.0 and 0.0, and one more value you have upper right corner of the window as 200, 150. Okay, so that means your window has displayed at somewhere on the lower left corner of the screen, entire screen. Okay, for now we will use world coordinate rectangle within the same aspect ratio as the display window, so that is there is no distortion of our picture. Okay, means your aspect ratio of the display window, whatever you have, you may have aspect ratio as 2:3, is it? So it has to be matching with the display screen also. Your display screen, if it is 2:3 range, then you can display the window also in 2:3 range. Okay, this aspect ratio. So finally, we need to call the appropriate OpenGL functions to create our line segment. The following code defines a two-dimensional line segment with the integer values. Okay, Cartesian and endpoints are defined with the values as 180, 150 and 150, 145. That means when you are saying a line segment, it is the line segment is drawn using vertices, two vertices, v1 and I name it as v1 and v2. Okay, v1 is given with the value 180, 15, and v2 gives has a value 10, 145. Okay, so now this has to be drawn on your computer screen as well. So we start writing the line segment using the vertices, with the help of vertices. So we are going to join the vertices, okay, and then we are going to draw it. So what are the functions here? So first and foremost thing is you have to give the function as GL begin. So this comes under GL library. Okay, this GL begin function is defined already in GL library. So we have written here GL begin, and the symbolic constant or the argument what you have written here is GL underscore lines. Okay, GL underscore lines. To draw this line segment, we have two vertices. Okay, how do you represent this vertex? Okay, that is, I said that first vertex is having the value x in along x axis. So two values you have, x and y values. Again, this another vertex also has got x and y values. The first vertex, that is 180, 15. How do you write it? Yes, GL vertex 2i. Okay, here 2 represents, that is you have used a two dimensional figure here, and I represents, it is an integer value whatever you have used. So 180 is an integer value, data type is an integer, and 15 is also an integer. So that's why I have written as I. Okay, 2 represents, it is a two dimensional 2D figure. And next you have one more vertex, that is v2. Okay, v2 is also GL vertex 2i, 10, 14, 145. okay, along x axis it is 10 and y axis it is 145. Somewhere you have represented P2, okay, and then at the end you have GL and. And remember that all the functions you have written you should end with semicolon. And see here, if you have GL begin, you should have AND also, GL AND. And remember that two vertices will make a line segment, okay. And suppose if you have one more vertex here, think that I have written one more value, GL vertex 2i, some value as 10, 10, okay. So that won't make a one more line segment. Why? Because any line, if you want to create, it should be with the even number, okay. It should not be odd. The number of vertices should not be odd. It should be always even, okay, to create any line. So suppose I say here one more line, think that sorry here, one more line I am taking here, okay. So this also has got two vertices, okay, two vertices. So the number is even here, okay. So GL underscore lines has got two vertices. Now we are ready to put all the pieces together and let us see how the program looks here. So let us start writing the program. So initially, the program what we have taken is to display a line segment. Here our example is to display a line segment. So first you have to include the header file, that is hash include gl slash glu2.h, okay. That means glut.h is a header file we have included. Depending on the system you are going to use, you can use either GL or GLU or GLUT.h, okay. Suppose if you are using GLUT.h, the GLU and GL header files are not needed, but any one header file is essential to display any content on the screen. So here our example we have considered hash include GL slash GLUT.h, okay, or glut.h. Next is one more function we have to define here, that is void init void, okay. So this particular thing, this init function will be called actually in the main, okay. So here let us see what are the functions you have included in init. That is gl clear color 1.0 1.0 1.0 and 0.0. so that means I am going to set the all the RGB colors to 1.0. That means you are going to set the background to white background, and alpha color, the last fourth parameters you have considered is 0.0. So this is will set the background color to transparent background, okay. So this is to GL clear color is to set the display window to white background. And next you have GL matrix mode GL underscore projection. So this will set the projection parameters, whatever the object you want to project or want to display on the screen will be in matrix values, okay. Next you have GLU auto 2D with the certain parameters, four values you have. It is 0.0, 200, 0.0 and 150. So this is going to set the object onto the window what you are going to set, okay, with the left value. From left it is 0.0 to from right it is 200, and bottom it is 0.0 and top it is 150. That means you have set some the window whatever you have created, and it has projected on the leftmost corner, left bottom corner of the screen, okay. Next you have the actual line segment whatever you want to display. We call a function called void line segment and void. And how do you write the function inside this line segment, okay. So since you have created, you want to display a line segment, it's a function with named it as line segment itself. And again, this line segment, you have got one more function, gl clear, gl underscore color underscore buffer underscore bit. So that means you are going to clear the buffer information into certain white background itself. That means something already the buffer information, okay, the buffer consists of all the information about the objects whatever you want to display, okay. The maybe you say color of the object information, color, okay. Maybe earlier you have the color information as red. That red color has to be cleared from the frame buffer, okay, or color buffer. That information has to be cleared and you have to display a new content on the screen. So that's why we have a clear buffer here, that is color buffer. You are going to clear it, okay, and you are going to have a clear display window on the screen. And next you have gl color 3f 0.0, 0.4 and 0.2. And this is all the RGB colors. R is set to 0.0, green color is set to 0.4, and blue color is set to 0.0. Okay, so red color is 0. Okay, and it's a combination of the line segment is has a color with the, it's a combination of green and blue color. Okay, and the value whatever you have is a three valued parameter you have, no, right? So three values means red, green and blue color you have taken. And f represents here, it's a floating point value. So this particular function will set the line segment to green color or green, or it's a combination of green and blue color, okay, here mainly. And next you have the line whatever you have, you want to display, suppose you want to display a line and it has got two vertices as the endpoints. Okay, now this vertices also has to be represented in the function. Okay, so that's why we write a set of routine here, that is starting with gl begin, and you have got argument as gl underscore lines. Okay, so this is the what you can say here is it's a constant what you have, gl underscore lines. Other parameters or arguments also you can pass, that is other arguments you have like gl underscore points. Okay, suppose if you want to draw a point on the screen, then you have to consider it as a gl begin, in the bracket you may write gl underscore points. But here our program is to display a line segment, so that's why we have written it as the argument as gl underscore lines. And the two vertices you have, that is with the two values x and y values. So it start with the 180 comma 15, 180 in x axis and 15 in y value, y axis. Okay, the vertex point you are mentioning here now. Okay, and it is again an integer value, 2i. It is 2i means I represents integer, and 2 is the two values you have passed here. Okay, and again the one more vertex you have, that is gl vertex 2i 10 comma 145. Okay, so this is representing one more vertex, maybe the other endpoint you say here. So one point is 180 comma 15 and other point is 10 comma 145. And I represents the integer value, and every begin has to be ended here. So gl begin function has to be ended with gl end function here. And next you have gl flush. Okay, gl flush, it's a function which moves all your pixels from frame buffer to the display window. So until you write this particular function gl flush, whatever the contents which was in the frame buffer will not be displayed on the screen. So every program you have to have a function called gl flush to actually move every content or pixel information, whatever you have in a frame buffer, has to be moved on the or displayed on the screen. Is it? So that's why we need to have this GL flush at the end. The next thing is we should also have a main in our function, that is void main. We have int argument count and character, that is argument vector. Okay, so this is the in almost all programs we write this kind of function. It's main function. Okay, and next within the main, what are the contents you are going to write is glut init ampersand argument count and comma argument vector. Okay, so this means you are going to initialize the glut now. Okay, and next thing is glut init display mode. You have under the inside this bracket what we write is glut underscore single. The parameter what we have passed is glut underscore single, and with an or logical symbol we have written. This is or, representing or, and glut underscore RGB. So this display, it will set the display mode to single buffer. Okay, so you see here we are using a single buffer. So any buffer, when you are saying, it contains two information. One is the color information and the pixel information. Okay, so now you have set the buffer to single buffer mode. Okay, and whatever the contents, the colors you want to display, it should be in RGB color. So that thing also we are going to mention. So this RGB informations, the color information will be present in the buffer itself. So that's why we have to mention this along with this buffer thing. Okay, you can have glut to double, glut underscore double also. That's when you are using a double buffer, we will be writing that. But here for this particular program, glut single is enough. Glut underscore single is enough for displaying the line segment. Okay. Next we have the window position. Always remember, it's quite different from Auto 2D. The window position always starts from the topmost value. Okay, that is 0.0. It will start from top left corner. Okay, so init window size 50, 100 means it may come over here. Okay, like this in the screen. Set top left display window position. Accent Y values it has given. Okay, window where it has to be displayed. Okay, 50, 100. Okay, in this position you have to start displaying your window, actual window, whatever you have created. Now the created window has got some title over here. Okay, the title is an example OpenGL program. So that thing will be displayed here. Okay, and example OpenGL program will be displayed on the window on this particular position, top position of the window. Okay, that is glut create window. And next we have init function. So this init function is already written previously. Already I have written. Okay, in init you had certain functions like GL clear color and GL matrix mode and GLU auto 2D. So all those informations already you have written. So how the display window has to be, everything you have mentioned in the init function. You have just to execute the initialization program now, procedure now. Okay, this will be called. And next here you have glut display function. Okay, what inside the bracket you have written line segment. Okay, this particular function will send the line segment, okay, or the object to the display window. And next you have glut main loop. Okay, so you have to have, now you think that you are going to display a line segment on the screen, is it? That line segment has to be continuously rendered on the screen. Okay, means every screen it will be refreshed continuously because it will have its own refresh rate. Is it? So that's why any object, whatever you are going to create, has to be in a continuous loop. Okay, that means continuously it has to display it until there is an interrupt. Okay, so interrupt will be coming from a human. Okay, human interrupt, it may be through keyboard or mouse. Okay, so until you click keyboard or mouse, your loop will be continuous. Okay, it will go for an infinite loop. Okay, until you give an interrupt. Okay, so this is main thing you should have in your program.